Greetings, and welcome to Spider McGowan Ports channel. This time, another wonderful Famicom cartridge, Final Fantasy 2. So, what we'll do is we'll take the cartridge apart, and we'll clean the contact pads, check the battery, make sure there's continuity across a lot of the contact pads, if there's any wear line or anything like that. But, everyone, I am just thrilled to have this as part of the collection. Yeah. It's going to be great. What we'll do is we'll go ahead and play the game real quick, check it out on the Sharp Twin Famicom, and then what I was thinking of changing it up just a little bit, and we could play it on the PlayStation so we can have an English translation and we can see the game in a more 16-bit fashion than it is on the 8-bit fashion of this one here. We'll still see this one, do a quick review on it, but I would really like to play the other game as well. So, yeah. That way we'll get more of the story arc. Yeah, that's gonna be. I had it imported from Japan, and it just arrived a few days ago with the other ones. And I'm just, having it tactile feel in your hand, like even through this, it's just, it's awe-inspiring. So let's see if we get this opened up a little easier. Oh, we're gonna do a couple bubble wrap pops too. Promised. So we can get. Want to get a couple of them. My apologies. The was it AMSR or ASMR? Which I get confused. I thought it was going to be a lot more, a lot more ate up, chewed apart, used. Yeah, I know I got some cleaning to do inside that, but awesome. So here comes the fun part. This is easy, taking the labels off, but getting these things open. So my apologies, is this going to be a little bit loud doing things in. I'll try to fix a lot of these things in post. But yeah, let's get this lined up properly here. Alright, this time I'm not gonna let it trick me with the camera. Last time he was trying to get me with the camera where it wasn't lining up properly. Let me see here now. Let me see this. Okay. See how it's like right, I was trying to get it right on the actual cart, that line itself. And then same thing with this side over here too. Like this one really lines up easy. It's the other one over here that I need to work on just a little bit. There we go. Alright, now this should just separate apart. But hopefully it doesn't slide off here. That's gonna. Sorry, everyone. It is a tricky process. Okay. Got it that time. Okay, this side right here is gonna pop open right away. That always kind of makes you jump too when it does finally free up. Sorry, I'll have to do it over again. Give me a second, I'm going to set it up off camera. My apologies, I brought the camera up a little bit too so you guys can see what I'm doing. But, now we can already see that it's doing its thing. I think I still need to bring it up a little bit higher. This time. Yes, we did. Oh. this side yet. It's all good. Here, I'll show it so that we can see it. It sounds more terrible than it actually is. And then I'll just close it back shut again and then put it back together again. Or, sorry, take it apart. Yeah, before I forget, sorry, I'm just messing around here. Give me 1 second here. And sorry, I got a little ahead of myself here. Do color coordinations. That's that right there. That's Mibu. Wait for the shell. Maybe it's here. Cool. And blue goes with the blue. Right there. Awesome, right? Okay. And before we even get started with this, I'm going to get the rest of that shell apart. So give me another second here. I'm going to go ahead and pause it and get it all lined up. Now, with any luck, this will come apart easier. We had the one apart, now we're going to have to worry about the other one. It's a little bit of finesse, and I finally got it apart now. Yay! That was a lot more longer than I thought it was going to take. Sorry about that, everyone. Let's see if I can get this apart now. Clean the inside of that. Looks good. Everything's all good on there too, and these are still there. Awesome. No cracks in the shell, nothing. Excellent. Now, now we can work on this. Give me a second. This should be very fast to clean. Yeah, I don't see any wear marking on that. Maybe just a little bit. Cool. Alright, so give me a second here. So you can get the numbers. If you need me to, I'll zoom in too. Okay, I am zooming in 3, 2, 1. Try to get a macro of it. That's so cool. All right. Wow, even the camera is staying focused too. I mean, as soon as it says something, it that's hilarious. All right, I'm gonna zoom out just a little bit so I can. There, I can get the whole board on screen there. Yeah, the only things that I can remember that I had played from Final Fantasy II was that your party, your entire party dies right away at the beginning of the game. I believe that's what I remember about it the most. Yes. And then that was from the actual PlayStation. That's not... But most of my gameplay has been the first one and four. Two on the Super Nintendo. I don't know, this is going to be amazing to see on screen. And actually be able to play it. You know, on actual hardware. Not through emulation. Yeah, another noticeable thing too is just I don't see that much flux on the board. Just a little bit over here. But that is one clean PCB. Nice. This is going to be very easy to shine up and clean up. Down to. Down in the comment section, tell me whether or not you guys got a chance to play Final Fantasy II either on the Famicom or a port or in English translation, modded one. I think that would be very cool. Wait to hear about it. All right. This is so much fun. This is my favorite pastime. Just grabbing a vintage video game and cleaning it up and restoring it back to as best possible condition. Pretty polished out there, don't they? Oh, hey, see, just recently I was asked, why do I have foam down and why do I color coordinate it? And there's a neat little story behind that. When I first started to clean these cartridges and take them apart, I had, at one point, only a small fraction of one of these foam pads available. And I thought it was so useful while I was working on projects to have these. Because, you know, they actually are the dimensions that I need. They're the proper thickness so that when I put the PCB right here like that on it, it allowed me to push a lot of pressure on the contact pads to clean them. Versus if it was just like that, it'd be... So, this is why I color coordinate. That's going to wash out. Sorry, guys. You notice that I'm using red, white, and blue. Happy Independence Day. Yep. I hope y'all had a wonderful Independence Day. Mine was great. I mean, I wanted to have the barbecue. I wanted to have the grill out and had a whole bunch of people over, but, well, Mother Nature objected to that. We postponed it. We may have it here in a couple days. I have a whole bunch of friends and family over. And have a nice little shindig. Well, you know there's no contact cleaner on that. That battery looks like it burst. Sorry, I need to put the camera here, but yeah, that battery looks... Apologies. I have to readjust this so it doesn't nick the board. Because we know this little metal tip right here will actually just, it'll mangle this if I'm not careful with it. Man, these Famicom cartridges are incredibly easy to clean. There's so little surface area to cover. Alright, so opening up these cartridges, I am, what, 4 to 4? Every cart that I've opened, they have been successfully opened without breaking anything on them. And all the games are functional, with the exception of one, which we've discussed numerous times already, but we don't need to overlap products and games. Okay, give me a second, I'm gonna clean up real quick. Yeah, if this had added audio channels to it, I'll get a sample of it. Thank you. Okay, sorry about that too. This is what I was referring to for Final Fantasy II. We'll play it on the PlayStation so we can see what it's like. And that is the cover art for the Famicom cartridge. That is so cool. Awesome. So yeah, we will see this version of it played a little more further than actually on the cartridge so that we know where we can go. You know, like we'd be able to, you know, the translated text. I think that'd be great. All right. Enough about that. Let's get this all buffed out and stuff. Maybe we can check it out on the console real quick. Okay. And I'm gonna skip doing that twice in a row when we could just go one time. I don't have to worry about that clicking noise with the light. And I'm looking for solutions. I'll find it. That's sweet. That looks really, really good. See the reflection of the cotton bud in the copper, or I like to call this brass. That looks great. Awesome. So now we can check voltage. New multimeter. It's awesome. Oh, cool. Even the board says positive right here. You know, 3 volt, or right where we're supposed to be at. That's okay. The battery's still good. It's not. I'm just kind of concerned about the discoloration, but then again, the cartridge itself has something in it. It really might be the battery burst. Sorry. Let me see if I can. I just really want to be thorough before I put that together again, because I'm sure these cartridges are only able to be opened up so many times before they start just to fall apart and crumble. You know, I could try something real quick here. Whatever the dirt's inside the cartridge, that's all it is. Sweet. I don't have to take the battery out of it yet. Yet. Not that I don't want to, it's just. Alright, so let's get this discoloration out of here. What do you think? You think that's. I think it's cigarette soot. Dirt. Awesome. there's a lot of garbage inside this cartridge. Looks like, creosote. I don't smell, coal or anything like that, or diesel fuel. Even an oxyacetylene workshop area. This could have been stored somewhere anywhere near that stuff, and it would be all lived inside of it. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and continue to scrub these, and then I'm gonna put that together again, and we will check it out on the console. A quick game of Final Fantasy 2 on the Sharp Twin Famicom. That font quality is really cool. So what I'll do next, after playing this for a little bit so you guys can see what it looks like. The cartridge works amazing. Contact pads turned out wonderful. Nice and polished. So what I'll do is I'll set up the PlayStation 2 and we'll play that maybe on a, I don't know, Unlisted, perhaps? Because, you know, I don't want to be part of the same video, if that's possible. But I still would like to be able to have the translated version of it, so you can see what that all was right there. So obviously you need an item to give to them to wake them up. It's just a bummer. Can't sleep in a bed. These are usually interpretable. You know, you can interpret yourself. There's like strength, vitality, dexterity. There's a chest. Thank you.
Now, was that an actual item to use to wake that person up? Yeah, see, I have no idea what's going on.
I've never played it.
I mean, I've seen it just in videos here and there of what to, like, what to expect. And I saw it right at the beginning of the year, whole entire party is toast. Looked like I already had items equipped to my character, so let's see what they do. Is it stun? It's not poison, otherwise my health would be going down. Must have been stunned. Or weakened or something like that. Let's save it and see if it actually holds the save now.
Alright, so I'm gonna hit reset. Power off real quick. Let's see if it held that save.
This one makes me a little concerned whether or not it holds a save. It does. Okay, good.
Awesome. Well, thank you all so very much for watching. Have yourselves a wonderful day. Be healthy, stay safe, and happy gaming, everyone.